Who's in the building?
It's I, Mr. Philip Sidowu, Olympic athlete, world champion, European champion, and British number one triple jumper. It's a pleasure.
That's what I'm saying. And like, your mantelpiece is definitely quite serious, but I still feel like you could walk down the road and maybe get away with it. Not everyone would recognize you, kind of thing.
Yeah, I've when I don't have my hair dyed red, I try to be a little bit inconspicuous. But now, it's when I walk around certain areas, walking around Hackney and Tottenham and places like that, I do get the recognition I deserve. So I get a lot of love from my people, and I massively appreciate that.
So from the jump off, man, you know, you're a silver Olympic medalist. That's what you won in 2008. Like, the heat is on. It's in London. You know what I mean? You're a Hackney kid, you
Hackney
know what I mean?
Boy,
like, a London kid. But like, the heat's on, man. Expectation is there for you to really step up, man.
It's good, you know. I embrace that. Like, I was born, raised and schooled in East London, so having the opportunity to come and compete in Olympic Games in my hometown is a once in a lifetime experience. And off the back of my massive disappointment from Beijing, I came away with a silver. There's no better story to come home and win that gold medal. So that's the plan, and that's what we've been working on for the last 4 years, so hopefully it'll come to pass.
Because there's a lot of people that definitely want you to do well. We're rooting for you. But a lot of the speculation at the moment is that you're injured, man. So like, this is one of the opportunities for you to set the record straight, man. Tell us about it, man. What's the current status with your health, man?
Well, like I said, I'm preparing for the games, and I knew there was a lot of rumours about me being injured. There was a lot of concern, and I used that as an opportunity for me to kind of take a step back from the public eye and the media and the press and just focus on training. So I've been doing my undercover work in some undisclosed locations, and I'm in pretty good shape. I'm in really good shape, and I'm optimistic about my chances. So I've got less than 30 days until I step out there and jump on in the Olympic Stadium. So it should be good. People, don't worry, man. I'm gonna hopefully do you proud.
Because it was the last competition that you pulled out midway through, isn't
it? Like, yeah, it was quite frightening, because it was my third competition of the year. I managed to squeeze in 3 comps within a month, traveling internationally. One from Portugal to China to the Netherlands, then over to the USA, and in the States it was rainy, it was wet. My third round attempt, I hit the board and slipped. So that kind of put the fear of God through me, and with it being Olympic year, you don't want to take any chances. And before I landed back in the UK off the back of that competition, the journalists had already printed the fact that I was hurt and I was injured, and I hadn't spoken to any of the written press at that time. So I used that as a chance to kind of take a step back. If people think I'm injured, then I'll let the rumour mill stir, and I can just focus on the job at hand, which is just train hard and work hard. And I've managed to do that.
So what it is, SK Vibe Make It in the building, and you know we bring through the best special guest, man. We got Philip Sidowu, man. He's definitely gunning for some definite glory at the Olympics, man, coincidentally held in London.
That's it. Always gold. That's the focus. Always gold. That's what I've been working for the last 4 years for, so hopefully I can bring it back.
Hopefully. I thought you'd be a bit more confident.
Nah, I'm confident, definitely, but I don't want to be arrogant about it. I do have a lot of respect for all my competitors, and any one of the 12 guys in the final are potential winners. I learned from experience. The last games, I went in undefeated from January right away up until August and led the world rankings, and I ended up missing out by 5 centimetres. So I always got to make sure that I respect the people that I'm competing against, because it only takes one good jump.
So do you think you had maybe a lack of respect before? Maybe it was a bit too cocky?
I wasn't cocky, to be honest. At the time, I was going into the final, I was massively nervous. But that's because I probably felt like I had it in a bag, and I was thinking too much about the gold and the podium and the national anthem and just all of that, as opposed to actually performing first. So now when I go into a competition, I understand the fact that there are 12 other people in there, and everyone else is probably training as hard as me. Everyone else is talented, otherwise you wouldn't be an Olympian. So it's a case of just making sure I've done more and I'm in a much better shape than everybody else.
Do you know that national anthem?
I do know it, yeah.
I rate you, because there's a lot of people that don't know that national anthem.
You know what? I've been on the podium a number of times, as you said, so I've got to know it. I know it. I know, I've heard it so many times in my career.
So, you know, like, there's been a few things conspiring, like, against you. The reason why it's been, a low-key for you heading up to the Olympics, like, you know, slightly with the speculation about your injury. But also, like, a lot of people would say you've kept it low-key when you could have cashed in a lot more, like, marketability. You're from Hackney, you know, a lot more sponsorship, and your face could have been plastered around more. Do you feel like that sometimes?
I feel like I have cashed in. Like, I'm not going to say I haven't. I have cashed in. I work with really good agents, and what they've managed to do is get me massive deals and get me really good sponsors who have allowed me to focus on my performance and the time that I need to train. So I'm not traveling from Birmingham to London to Manchester, all over the country, trying to do photo shoots and commercial shoots. They allow me to go and train and focus on training, focus on competing. And we even managed to get a lot of my commercial done in the back end of 2011. So that come 2012 now, I don't have to do much. So I've got little snippets of things going out there, little billboards, little commercials, but I don't feel like I need to be everywhere. To be honest, the main goal is to win Olympic gold. And it's a great opportunity for Olympic athletes, being an athlete competing in the home games, that you can cash in now and you can get your face all over the country if you choose to. But it's a lot of work and you've got to find the right balance. And I think my agents have worked with me well to make sure that my main priority is always training. So even some of the commercials you may have seen me doing, they would have been incorporated in with a training session of mine. So I'm not losing out.
Because you know what it is? Like, the reason why I asked that is because at a time I thought maybe you was getting a lack of press. I thought maybe that the press was maybe favouring some of the other athletes.
Yeah.
Because I see Jessica Ennis all over the place.
Yeah. That probably works in my favour as well. I always like my performance to kind of show out, and I'm in a really difficult event. It's tough for me to go out there. My whole career has been like that. I've competed against the world record holder in the event. I've been doing it for 12 years now, and I competed against a really great Swedish athlete who was also a former Olympic champion, and he had massive jumps in his legs, and then the same thing against my Portuguese rival. So I never have an easy ride, so I've always got to make sure that my performance kind of rings true. And over the last 6 years, I've always managed to win a medal, generally gold, but a couple of times it's been silver.
It's
but
just
yeah,
that Olympic gold that's eluded you a
that's the only one that eludes me. But to be honest, after my disappointment in Beijing, I the nation would have seen me crying and I looked a hot mess, but yeah, I was disappointed because I wanted the gold, but knowing that I get the opportunity to correct that in my hometown in East London, I see that silver medal as a silver lining for me.
Because, like, I was surprised before when you said that you would have retired in Beijing if you would have got the gold.
Yeah, I wasn't definite. It wasn't a definite statement. I just thought that I probably would have lost the hunger for the sport. I wouldn't have been as inspired to continue, because as an amateur athlete, the pinnacle of your sport is to be Olympic champion, get an Olympic gold medal. So at that time I was 29 years old, so if I'd won that gold medal by that time, I probably would have thought, well, there's no need for me to kind of go on and hurt my body. It's a stressful event doing a triple jump and jumping the distances that I do, so I don't think it's something that I would have wanted to do any longer. Winning that silver medal, like I said, is a silver lining, because off the back of that, I managed to go on and win a world title the following year, jumping a PB that time. And then the following year after that, I went on to win a European title, jumping another PB. And then last year, 2011, I unfortunately picked up a silver medal, but I had a really good series of jumps. It was a consistent series of jumps, and any one of my jumps, barring the guy who won the competition, he had a massive big freak jump, and barring that, any one of my jumps in that competition would have won the event. So I was pleased with my performance then, and we've used that, and we're planning wisely to go in and put in a consistent series of jumps, but also we've got that big one in the bag.